Good morning, students. Today we are going to see a new lesson, reproduction in plants and animals. What is reproduction? Reproduction is the process of producing young ones of the same kind. In our classes you have studied this definition. Reproduction is process of producing young ones of the same kind. The word young one and same kind is very very important. Okay. Then, what are the modes of reproduction? Reproduction takes place in two ways. One is asexual, the other one is sexual. Asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction are the two types of reproduction. What's the difference between asexual and sexual reproduction? Asexual reproduction, the gametes are not involved. The gametes are not being produced. Whereas in sexual reproduction, gametes are produced. Okay? So that's the main difference between the asexual and sexual. Asexual, only one parent is involved. Sexual, two parents are involved. Okay? Two individuals are involved in sexual reproduction. Whereas asexual, one individual. There is no need to have two individuals. Okay. Next, asexual reproduction in plants. In plants, the asexual reproduction takes place by spores, production of spores, fragmentation, vegetative propagation. Spores, if we take moss plant, it will produce sporangiophore. And this sporangium produces spores. When the spores are, the capsule is filled with, this is called capsule, it is filled with spores, it breaks and liberates the spores. The spores, when they reach the substrate, they will germinate into a new plant. Okay? Even in fungi, we can see this, but fungi is a separate kingdom we have given. So we are taking this one as spore formation, moss plant as an example. So here they are not producing any seeds, okay, only the spores. Next one, fragmentation. If you take Spirogyra, an algae, Spirogyra, this algae, body of algae is called thallus. It is aquatic. It lives in water. Due to the water current, it breaks into pieces and each piece will develop into a new plant. The cells undergo division and produce new thallus. So this is called fragmentation. Next comes the vegetative propagation. Vegetative parts in flower, seed, fruit and all reproductive parts. Root, flower, seed, fruit, reproductive part, stem, leaf, vegetative parts. Stem, leaves and root are vegetative parts. These vegetative parts, they have root, leaf, stem. They have their own function. Other than that, they can propagate. Propagation also they can do. So that vegetative propagation, if any new plant is produced by the root, by the stem, by the leaves, it will come under asexual reproduction. That elaborately we are going to see the types of vegetative propagation. The next, other than these plants, other organisms, asexual reproduction takes place by budding and binary fission. By budding, if you take hydra, a small bud appears with produced tentacles, then it will get detached and lead independent life. Okay, so this is an example for budding. Then binary fission, we take amoeba. The cell divides into two. And produce two daughter amoebae. Okay, this is binary fission. One cell divides into two. Suppose the plenty of food and the water is there, the favorable condition, they produce more number. This divide into two, each one will divide into two, so it will increase in number, multiple fission. If the condition is unfavorable, the amoeba withdraw all the pseudopodia. And become secrete a thick coat over this, over the cell membrane, and form as a swarm. Inside this, the cytoplasm and the nucleus undergo division and form number of spores. If the pond is dry, this is what happens. Then it drains, the pond will be filled with water. So, a favorable condition, this coat breaks and each one will develop into a, each spore develop into an amoeba. Okay, so all these are the asexual reproduction seen other than plants, other organisms. Okay, next we are going to see the vegetative propagation in plants. Vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation takes place naturally and artificially. It can be done. Naturally, by vegetative parts, already I mentioned, root, stem and leaf. Root. If you take this sweet potato, tuber, root tuber, it will produce small tiny plants. That will get detached and develop into a new plant. Okay, so this is example for this root. Then stem, subaerial stem and underground stem, both involved in vegetative propagation. Subaerial stem, strawberry and grass, if you see grass, it will be seen, the stem will be seen on the ground. If you pull a bunch of grass, it will come like a chain, because it will be like this. Each node, the stem is seen horizontal, each node produces a leaf and roots. So if we cut here, this will develop into new grass plant, this will develop into new grass plant. Okay, so this is through stem, subaerial stem, vegetative propagation takes place. Next, underground stem, under the ground, the stem is, some stems are grown underground, and corm, if you take the gladiolus corm, this the stem will be like one big mass, okay, horizontal and fleshy. The fleshy portion of the stem will have nodes. From each node, small tiny plants will come. Okay, that plant will grow, develop into a new individual. That is example for, at one of the example for underground stem. Next, onion bulb. If you cut the onion, you can see like this, all these are fleshy leaves. In between the fleshy leaves, the axillary buds. And this one is the terminal bulb. The portion what we are cutting and throwing it out is nothing but stem. It produces root. So this axillary bud and terminal bud, if you keep the onion along with this root in the soil, it will grow into a new onion plant. It will produce shoots. These axillary buds and terminal buds will produce shoots. Okay. So through bulb, they reproduce vegetatively. The next comes the rhizome. Ginger is an example for rhizome. Ginger is stem, it is not a root. Though it is seen brown in color underground, it is stem because it has nodes and internodes. And if you see near the nodes, you can see the scale leaves. Near the scale leaves, buds will be there. If you keep this ginger in the soil, this buds will grow into a new ginger plant. Okay, these are the roots will be formed from the stem. So that is rhizome as an example for underground vegetative propagation. Next comes potato. Potato is a stem tuber. This also brown in color, growing under the ground, but it is stem tuber. The potato stem, some part of the stem will grow towards the ground. When they reach the ground, they form, the accumulation of food takes place there and forms the tuber. And if you see this tuber, it will have depressions like this, and each one is called eye. Each eye will have a bud. Okay, so if you keep it in fridge for few days or wrap it with a wet cloth, these buds will grow. If you keep it in the soil, it will grow into a new potato plant. Okay, so that is about by the tuber, underground stem. All these are natural growth. Then leaf, if you take the leaf, bryophyllum, in Tamil they used to say katti pota kutti podum. Bryophyllum, the leaves, see, I think you can see a tiny tiny plant growing on the leaves. This is the bryophyllum leaf. If the water is plenty during the rainy season only, it used to produce tiny plants like this, but by God's grace, now in summer season, it's growing in our house. So this leaf, see, the leaf margin produces tiny plant. This tiny plant will get detached and reach the soil, it will grow into a new plant. Okay, so this leaf is producing a young plant. Okay, so leaf, bryophyllum, the leaf is producing young plant, vegetative propagation through leaves. Okay. Then, artificial, all these are naturally, no one is telling this should happen. Next, artificial vegetative propagation. Artificial vegetative propagation by cutting, stem cutting, rose and drumstick, many plants, they are cultivated by keeping the stem cutting. And we have to take a branch, remove the leaves and keep this stem in the soil in such a way we are leaving one or two nodes under the soil and leave it, water it, and we can close it with this cut portion. You must keep moist by tying with a wet cloth. After some time, you can see new branches arise from this node. So it will develop into a new plant. Only one stem cutting only we have taken, but we got the plant. Okay. Then layering. If we have this kind of jasmine, we can do layering in jasmine plant easily. We have to select a long branch. All these are artificial methods. Okay. Long branch. And bend that branch, remove this leaves at all near this, leave two or three nodes and keep this branch in the soil and another pot and keep a stone over that because it will come up again. So keep a stone over this and water both the pots. After 15 to 20 days, if you remove the stone and see, you can see the roots on the surface of the soil itself. That means this plant, the roots are formed in the nodes. So that time you can cut this, and now we got another plant. We are using only one branch, layering. This method is called layering. We got now two plants. Next one is grafting. If you have two varieties, see, I am having one mango plant which is producing big fruits but no taste, and my friend is having a mango plant which is producing a small fruit, very tasty. We want a big tasty fruit, correct? So I am getting a branch from my friend. I have to take my branch and make a cut like this and insert the branch what I brought it from my friend. Okay, this one is producing small, tasty, and this is my plant, big, tasteless food. And after this, we have to tie this with a cloth and water. What happened? This will grow, this cut branch what I brought from my friend, no, it will grow into a new, it produces branches. And one thing is, this branches may produce the fruits either big tasty or small tasteless, we can't say. Okay, but two varieties of we are combining and forming, getting a new variety. So this is called as grafting. Okay, this is one of the artificial vegetative propagation grafting. Next comes the tissue culture. Okay, we are not getting any plant or twig or any water plant like this, only one leaf we got. Okay, from that we want to get the plant. For that, we can do in biotechnology, they can develop new plants from the from a small part of the plant. Okay, so because these plants are having, the plant cell is having the capacity to develop into a entire plant. That is called totipotency. Totipotency is seen only in plant cell. So what they will do, they will take the part, whichever vegetative part, especially the leaves, and they will keep it in the culture medium, moraric medium, the test tube, culture medium, and they will allow this cells, tissues in the culture medium. They will add all the enzymes, the hormones which are required for this cells to undergo division. And cells undergo division and differentiation. They differentiate into root, stem, leaf. Tiny plant cells will appear on this surface of this culture medium. They can transfer it to the pot. That is called hardening. That's a very big process. In short, I'm telling, this is from the tissue we are getting the plants. Okay? So tissue culture. All these will come under artificial vegetative propagation. Okay? Next we are going to, so with this we are finishing asexual reproduction. Next we are going to see sexual reproduction in plants and human beings. Okay?